variables for both nutrition, safety, and values. And I started this way back when, and I was one of the first people I know to give up partially hydrogenated oils when all my other friends looked at me and thought I was nuts. And the food industry was still saying that they were safe. And so I looked at GMO, I buy organic if I can, but I have three teenage boys, ages 15, 15, 16, and they're into sports. So, you know, I can control what comes into the house to a certain amount. They're going to buy a certain amount. And I can only afford organic for a certain percentage of what I buy. And right now, you know, my biggest issue with the GMOs is the excess use of herbicides. And I would like to be able to look at a bag of tortilla chips and have an idea if there's a greater chance that excess pesticides were used if it's not organic. These are some of the things that I'd like to buy, and I currently, I think, have to make a compromised choice there because I don't have all the information that I should be able to have. So I'm asking you to pass this bill without effective date restrictions. Just possibly, it might be, you know, hopefully it was not sued or not, but imagine the PR nightmare of suing a state full of farmers. I think that would not be, it wouldn't work out to the best. And one thing that I did see in the bill is that animals fed a GMO diet would be exempt from being labeled, and I think that's a miss because of the pesticides and the animals that are eating those and how that's building up in their bodies and in the muscle. So thank you.